direct from Studio A of the Howell Cheney Technical High School Media Production Shop, it's HCTV News.
Hi, I'm Morgan Landry.
And I'm Taylor Rinaldi.
Well, it's finally June and we're approaching the end of the school year, and we have quite a show for you today, starting things off with a report on the recent statewide SkillsUSA competition. We also talked to Cheney Tech Mantaver David Oliver about his fantastic photography, and we also have our segment Shop News. This week, we will be talking to Automotive about their coolest tool.
On the last episode of HCTV News, we presented the top three spots from our Digital Media Shop SkillsUSA competitions. Today, Junior Kiara Franklin reports on the SkillsUSA competition that was recently held at Wilcox Tech.
This is a competition held at Wilcox Tech and some construction trade union halls. It lasted all day. Let's get into it.
Friday, April 1st, a digital media crew and I were in Meriden for the annual state competition for SkillsUSA. SkillsUSA is a national career and technical student organization serving more than 320,000 high school and college students and professional members.
At the start of the day, competitors were welcomed by CTHSS Superintendent Nivia Torres and Connecticut Lieutenant Governor Nancy Wyman.
It is our 39th conference, and we're very proud to be here today. Students, enjoy the day. I know we're here to compete, but truly it is the memories and the experience that you receive today that matter. So felicidades, enjoy the day.
Yeah. Listen, you've done a lot to get where you are today, and you should be proud of yourselves. And all I want to say to all of you, that you are very, very special students in our state. You really are.
More than 1,200 students compete in more than 30 shop competitions, including automotive, cabinet making, hairdressing, graphics, nursing, and more.
I think a lot of hard work goes into today's events. All year long, people work on preparing, and the competitors prep for months on end, and then we have chairpersons that prep months in advance. Then we have, you know, the union halls that host the events and all of our other host schools. So I think it's a great event and it's a lot of teamwork, which is really cool.
Well, I think technical high school education is extraordinarily important, especially for today's economy. When we talk about having a skilled gap, we really need students and people in industry to fill that workforce gap that we're experiencing.
The real advantage of the technical high school system is when you finish, you not only get your high school degree, you can also have skills that you can, you know, if you choose to do that, you can, or if you want to go on to college, you can. But it's always something to fall back on.
The importance of the technical high school is that you, in essence, have a dual degree. Students leave with their high school diploma and a certification or credential in their trade area. It gives them a unique opportunity to impact workforce development in the state of Connecticut.
After the competitions ended, we went to New Britain High School, where the award ceremony took place. Students arrived at the school around 6:30 for the awards, which ended at about 9:30. The first place winners in each competition will compete again in the National Conference in June in Louisville, Kentucky, where more than 6,000 students and 1,500 professionals will gather around from the country.
I think it's absolutely wonderful to seeing all these students from the technical high schools getting together, and they might be competing, but really, to be honest with you, all of them are winners. Our technical high school system is a fantastic school system, and we have the greatest kids in it.
The end of the year is coming up rapidly, and many events are happening. There's the senior trip to Six Flags, Art in the Park, the senior trip, the award ceremony, the dental van at Cheney, Olympic Day, AR celebration, graduation practice and senior luncheon, graduation, and the last day of school. Here are the details.
The senior trip to Six Flags is after school on Friday, June 3rd, starting at 4 p.m.
Art in the Park is taking place Sunday, June 5th, starting at 10 a.m. and ending at 4 p.m.
The senior trip takes place Monday, June 6th, to Holiday Hills, a 200-acre resort on Lake Barkley in Prospect during the school. Facilities include pools, athletics, and much more. It seems pretty fun to me.
The annual student award ceremony takes place on Wednesday, June 8th from 8:30 to 9:30. Congratulations to all the award winners.
A dental van will be coming the same day, Wednesday, June 8th, sometime after the award ceremony. So if you've already signed up, you'll be contacted for your appointment.
The always fun Olympic Day will be taking place Thursday, June 9th from 8:30 to the end of the day. But if it rains, it'll take place the next day, Friday, June 10th.
The AR celebration will be on Friday, June 10th at 12:20 to 1:45.
Graduation practice will take place on Wednesday, June 15th and Thursday, June 16th in the morning. Senior luncheons will follow rehearsal on Wednesday at Dave & Buster's and on Thursday at Outback Steakhouse.
Our seniors will graduate Thursday, June 16th at 6:30 in the evening.
Last but not least, it's everyone else's last day of school on June 17th.
Those days are approaching rapidly, and soon enough, all this fun will be over.
But students and staff will enjoy their summer, so that's all that matters.
You know, Cheney staffers have a lot of talent that most of us aren't familiar with.
David Oliver used to work in the cafeteria, and now he's a new maintenance guy. You probably haven't seen him because he started work after school hours. He's very passionate about photography and has a professional photography practice. Check out his beautiful artistic photos in this profile.
My name is David Oliver, and I am a maintainer here at Cheney Tech on second shift. I started my interest in photography during my high school days at East Hartford High School. We learned how to utilize a camera, how to develop a negative, and also how to print from that negative to make prints. So that's when it first started for me, and I kind of fell in love with it. So to go from that to digital was a little bit of a transition for me. I was a little afraid to do it, but with my printing background, I had some knowledge about that, about photos and digital, working digitally. So I did make the switch over finally, and it's been fabulous. Yeah, I love digital work. Yeah, I have a Nikon D750. That's my primary workhorse for me. And I love using my 80 to 200 2.8 lens. The style that I like to do is called, it's editorial style, editorial photography. And I use that style to tell stories about my clients. A young little girl, she's about 3 years old, that happened to be at a place where I was photographing, and she was just a real ham. She had a lot of personality. So I kind of followed her around. I played with her a little bit, let her get to know me a little bit, and then I started photographing her, just doing her thing. And the photo is of her kind of standing between some people with her hand on her hip and kind of giving me a real serious look. And it really came out good because the depth of field that I used was really good for that shot. So you have to learn your craft. That's lighting, camera, how the camera operates, all different scenarios. So that's probably first and foremost. That's the biggest thing. Second would be, I think, having the correct equipment with you and thinking ahead. If you interview your client and ask enough questions about who they are and what they expect out of this photo session, you can come up with the right stuff to have with you. And that's another big part of it, is knowing your client and telling the correct story and having the proper tools to do that. It's a photo of an engagement session that I was doing, and the female wanted to shoot on location where the location site was meant something to her. She hiked a lot. So there was this park in Vernon that she wanted to have the photos done at. And then he wanted photos done where he worked, which is a trolley museum, which was kind of interesting. So while we're at the park, he was like a dud. And but when we got to the trolley museum, he perked right up. But what changed was, and this was the big part, is she became a ham. Like, I would do some shots of him with her way in the background, almost blurred out, so the depth of field was shallower. And she was doing all kinds of weird poses in the background, just making it a fun shoot, which made for real nice photography. And then I had them take a break. They were by a trolley. The trolley was inside a barn being worked on. So we're standing by there, and I had to make some camera changes, and I just asked them to relax for a minute and allow me to make some changes. Well, they really relaxed, and I got some great shots of them not knowing that I was shooting them, and I turned one of those into an art piece. It's it really came out good, and it actually won some awards. So, but I changed my photography, and I actually make them pieces of art, and that's where my passion really lies, is there.
His work is amazing. His equipment is very professional, and he uses it well. We're about halfway into the show, and we'd like to remind you that if you like the show, you can subscribe in order to make sure you don't miss a video.
From time to time, we run a segment called Shop News, where we report on interesting things going on in the shops. This time, we're starting a series in Shop News called Cool Tools. Our automotive shop has a great professional tool they use called a scan tool.
Sounds interesting. What is it?
It's a tool you can use to hook up to your vehicle to check out certain information about your car and if anything's wrong with it.
All right. Well, don't spoil it. Let's see what it's all about.
My name's Dave Morello, and my shop is Automotive Technology. What I have here is a scan tool. Its function is to read live data from your engine and your powertrain. We plug in to a connector under the dashboard, and we read things like engine coolant, your O2 sensor voltage, all your sensors, any glitches that come up. People say a check engine light's on. Usually there's a reason for an engine light. And this tool will tell us what the problem is.
Here we have an electronic diagnostic scanner. And what it does is it allows us to communicate with the car's computer. So if the customer reports a problem, we can just plug this in under the dash and it'll let us access all of the car's files. So say they've reported a strange noise from the engine, we'd go into the scanner setting. And then we would select the make of the vehicle, which this is a Volkswagen, and then narrow down some selections as to like what year it is and what submodel, and then the engine and all that stuff. And then we have to get into one of these settings here, which is various systems in the car. So it could have an engine problem in this case, or transmission, brakes, or other things like your air conditioning or airbags. So for an engine problem, we'd click on engine management, and then it has to verify that we're gonna let it talk to the computer, and that takes a minute. So it's requesting it. And then it can be used to find codes that indicate problems or clear codes and do tests to see if the engine's functioning properly. So right now I'm going to check it for codes to see if there's anything wrong. And this one's perfectly fine, so there are no codes present and not a problem.
Oh, we would not be able to work on today's cars without it. There's simply no way. We need it every day. This is invaluable.
That's crazy how a tool and a car can work together so well. Sort of like how Cheney Tech students worked with rebuilding together to help the landscaping of a home.
Students went to Manchester on a Saturday to help out a house owner on their yard. The group mowed, raked, laid down mulch, and did many other jobs to clean it all up.
How helpful of them. Let's get it rolling.
Students, parents, and teachers from Cheney Tech came out to 169 Dartmouth Road, Manchester, Connecticut, and helped clean the home that was in need of yard work.
Rebuilding Together is a nationwide program to help people in need, low-income families, improve their property, whether it's painting, carpentry, yard work. Manchester had 800 people today and 82 projects.
Rebuilding Together's main mission is together we transform the lives of low-income homeowners by improving the safety and health of their homes and revitalizing our communities. In 1973, a group of people in Midland, Texas, realized a growing need in their community. They worked together to brighten up the homes of their community. News of the group's work spread to national recognition. In the month of April every year, people come together from all walks of life to help their neighbors. The students of Cheney Tech raked leaves, weed whacked, mowed the lawn, cut branches, and spread mulch.
From this experience, I think they have a little more idea what it's all about volunteerism, giving back to the community, and I think they feel pretty satisfied when they've done it.
Many of the students felt happy and proud that they got to help out for the project. The owner was happy, and overall, it was a great success.
They're quite grateful. They're quite grateful. We've had people call up and thank us, and it's good for the school to do this.
I love when students work together to help out the community.
Me too.
Hey, is that a Hawaiian punch?
Yeah, Hawaiian punch, my favorite.
Wow, product placement much?
Well, yes. This brings us to a story done by senior Brett Gentry about product placement in movies, TV, and online video.
Let's get to it.
The fact is, he's the sponsor. And you signed a contract guaranteeing him certain concessions, one of them being a spot on the show.
Well, that's where I see things just a little differently. Contract or no, I will not bow to any sponsor.
It's like people only do things because they get paid. And that's just really sad.
Hi, I'm Brett Gentry. Product placement is prominent in media. It's the brand name or item that's been paid to be featured in a film or video. It can even be punchline of a joke.
I'm feeling a little thirsty right now. You know what would really hit the spot? My favorite beverage, the 2016 Mini Club Man.
We sat down with Cameron Lovett to find out more on his view on product placement.
Start off with this here. Do you like some hand sanitizer here?
Some Purell hand sanitizer? Why, I wouldn't mind. Hey, that's enough. So product placement, I think, has always been around in different forms of media, like movies and TV shows and games and everything. But now it's just a lot more prominent and more people are noticing it because I think more people know what's happening behind the scenes of everything. So they're noticing things like product placement, especially movies like Castaway, where the whole story started off around FedEx and then his best friend was a Wilson volleyball, which like you clearly see, and then he names the volleyball Wilson, and then he says it probably 100 times throughout the movie.
I'm sorry, Wilson! Wilson, I'm sorry!
So it's just engraved into anyone who watches it, so they know the brand, and they probably got a lot of money for that. I've seen movies like Back to the Future, where they make things like a DeLorean more popular. It's not like that's a big brand, but it's something that people are buying and what everyone thinks of when they think of the movie is the product that was in it.
When it's done poorly, it shows, and critics definitely take note.
Oh, whoa. Where'd this card of Pepto-Bismol come from? Here, take a close look at that. It's not even subtle. They're literally leaning on a cart full of Pepto-Bismol products and acting like, hey, this is just what's going on. Oh, is that a Diet Coke? He's holding it so conveniently placed towards the camera. It's almost hard to believe that's a coincidence.
Hopefully now you'll notice more marketing and media. I'm Brett Gentry.
Well, that's all we have for you in this edition of HCTV News.
Don't forget that if you like this episode of HGTV News, give it a thumbs up and a subscribe to make sure not to miss any future HGTV News or other content from the Digital Media Shop.
Signing off, I'm Taylor Rinaldi.
And I'm Morgan Landry.
See you next time.